market makers tend to trade in a range. They work the best when they trade in a range. So when there's a lot of volatility in the market, you just have to have a bot or configuration that's set up with much wider spreads. But definitely I would say the only way to really kind of handle volatility is, I mean, you can hedge with futures, but that's a bit more of an advanced topic. But I would probably say that the most important thing is scaling in and scaling out of positions. So, you know, having that wide spread is important, but probably invest or trade with only what you can afford to lose. I think that's very, very important because sometimes we run Hummingbot. So for example, we have a live instance of it running right now where, you know, it was market making between $9,200 and $9,300, but our limit orders filled outside of $9,200. So we have got two choices. One is we can leave the bot running. And right now I've got limit orders that are going to fill at 93 and above, but I have to wait because it's already filled all the buy orders. Now, if Bitcoin continues to drop, then I'm essentially a bag holder and I have to hold Bitcoin. So then you have to make the conscious decision, okay, do I stop Hummingbot now and then I just execute all the Bitcoin that I've bought at a market order or a limit order? So sometimes we do that, and this is where the human part comes in, because sometimes the bot doesn't go back into the wave of the limit orders, right? So that's probably the part where there was some volatility. So for example, it was trading in the range of 90, 92 to 93 for about 36 hours. Then it broke out of that range. Now it's trading in the 92 to 91 and 9,000 range. So I have a bunch of my sell orders above. So this is kind of where you have to be a trader and really look at, okay, do I think the market's going to recover or do I think it's going to drop?
I see.
And by the same token, if you think the market is going to go up, well, you don't want to have your market maker execute all of the sales for you. Stop your market maker and wait for the price to go up. You know, do some maths. If it's going up, you know, set very, very clearly defined exits as well. And don't be greedy. At least in our organization, is that it's just another trader on our team, right? But it's a trader that we tell it what to do. And pretty much when it's out of the range, and it's like, okay, I can't trade anymore because I don't have enough money or whatever. And this is also another very important thing, is create a dedicated account just for Hummingbot versus your proprietary trading. So I try not to mix the two.
I think they have this conception that, you know, like if they kind of share their strategy and everyone's going to use it, and, you know.
Yeah, and I think it's interesting that people think that. Because I think in the show Billions, it says, even if I show people all my trades and I showed them like the algo I'm using and everything else, just because you can watch a karate movie doesn't mean you know karate, right?
Yeah, yeah.
No. It's the same thing. I can tell you about my strategies all day long, kind of what I use. And I'm very, very open about kind of what we trade. But guess what? How I determine when do we enter and exit, how we size positions, that's all. Even if I gave you my strategy today, it wouldn't necessarily work tomorrow. It depends on the market. I'll even give you a very, very simple trading strategy I use right now. I buy when the market is red and I sell when the market is green. Most people cannot do that. So for example, today, we thought the price, everybody thinks the price is going to keep going like below 9,000, and we just keep buying at 9,000, and then it goes back up. But it could keep going down. So rather than just, you know, blowing your entire wad all at once, you know, you scale into a position. So if you think the price is going to go down, you buy some at 9,000, you buy some at 90 or 89, 90, or, and then 88, 80. So you scale in. And I just use simple math, 1%, 0.5% between all the orders. And then if the market hits them and fills, then great. You just place your limit orders. And I think that this is why, for people to use Hummingbot effectively, they really need to understand trading. We're not trading that much.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll still execute maybe in a single day, if it's really, really busy, we might execute like 30, 40, 50 different trades. Yeah. But we're not executing thousands of trades per minute. So what's important is when you trade on exchanges such as Kraken and Binance. Now, Kraken's awesome. If you trade more than 10 million bucks, you pay 0% fees. Mm-hmm. So then you can set limit orders and you have much more narrow spread. So that's what we do. Binance, you know, if you buy BNB after you trade like 50 Bitcoin, mm-hmm. You end up paying, I think, like 5 basis points.
Yep.
So you can have more narrow spreads.
Right.
So it's important to find exchanges that, you know, you can have narrow spreads to, because the more narrow the spreads, the more you can trade. And if you, and look, you're only as good as your last trade. So, and losing is part of trading too. You have to be okay to take a loss. I think some traders aren't used to taking a loss, or they don't. Like, wouldn't you rather lose like 0.2%? We have a very, very amazing, interesting philosophy where it's like cut losses quickly and let your winners run. That's really, really what we try to do. And even we get caught, you know, sometimes. Nobody likes losing, but the more you learn to lose in trading and quickly, like lose quickly and just small amounts, like minimizing your losses quickly is probably the most important thing in success to trading. Cut losses quickly. Psychology, like the psychology art of trading, all that kind of stuff is super important if you're a trader.
Right.
Super important.